Welcome back. It's your partner, Hemi Amere. Now, let me tell y'all something, man, that I just went through. I just did a whole video, right? And I was closing out. I was at the very end when the truck pulled up, right? The truck pulled up, and I was like, you know what? I'll move. You know, he was like, no, you good, man. I can do this, man. I can whip. I was like, okay, cool. Go ahead and do your thing, man. So he whipped it in there, man. Did his thing, man. Reminded me of when I was driving, you know, overseas and shit, man. 88 Mike, man. Holla at your boy. But he pulled into the spot, man. I was like, you know what? Forget it, man. Let me just go ahead and pull off and find a different spot, man. So I don't be looking weird in front of somebody. You know, I should have just stood there and just gave him my information, told him that I'm Hemi Amere, and told him to subscribe to my channel. Oh, your boy don't be thinking sometimes. Anyway, so I pulled over here to my favorite spot. Y'all know, goes to him. I need to get back in there. But I pulled up over here, man, and guess what? Hold on, don't guess yet. I go over the video trying to figure out where I was at last on the video, and the whole video was corrupted. It's the sound that was corrupted. I'm gonna tell you why the sound was corrupted. Because I'm using a selfie stick, and I had this motherfucker plugged in. You know how, dude, man, that hurt. That hurt a little bit, man. Because I felt like I did really good on that video, man. Wasn't really breathing hard. You know how I'm breathing hard in all my videos, man, because I'm fat. Anyway, you know what? Let me go ahead and bust it down again and do the right thing. I'm gonna get it right this time. I'm gonna get it right again. So anyway, topic of this video is the two questions that I was asked about to do. I was asked to do a video of. See, I'm messing up already. I did way better the last time, man. Anyway, you already know me. I go straight, no chasing. Anyway, but before I really got into that, I was trying to, I showed you guys something on the video that was corrupted. But let me go ahead and show you again. It's not even really showing you again. But let me go ahead and show you what I started off with. A couple of things, two things. And then I was asked two questions. So I'm going to show you these two things. We're going to talk about it real quick. And then I'm going to do the two questions. I spent more time on one question than I did the other. A lot more time, because I had to really get into it. So let me show you this real quick. I got damn bird shit on my car. Pissed about that. But let's go ahead and do this real quick. Man, I promise y'all, I washed my car. Well, I didn't wash, but I rinsed my car off. I was supposed to wash it today, but I ended up going to rinse it. I get home, and this happens. This happened tonight. And then I have stuff on the back of my car. You can't see that because it's dark, but on bright cars, dirt and everything show real clear. So clear. But anyway, you guys know I love this situation right here. These LEDs on the interior. You guys see this? Look at that. Them interior LEDs are it. But this right here, let's see if y'all can see this before I even scroll over there. Bright. Super effing bright. I'm gonna have to change these to a lower lumen. I need some softer LEDs for there. Hold on, let me switch this around. I need some softer lumens, man. I don't know the lumens that I actually bought, but I gotta switch it up to some lower lumens. That's too bright. I can't even see myself in the vanity mirror because it's so bright. So I gotta get something softer. But nothing like them yellow lights. I'm not doing them yellow lights again. All right. Maybe y'all heard that. Maybe y'all didn't hear it. Maybe y'all can't hear it. Anyway. Something just happened. I'm not going to talk about it. If you heard it, then you heard it. I don't give a fuck. Anyway. Two questions was asked. And it might have been more questions, but I remember these two. First question. Somebody wanted me to do an install video or talk about the, I think he called it a boost box, but I know what you mean, man. So I'm not, if you know what somebody means, man, just roll with it. Don't sit there and just bother people, man. I know what you mean. I know what he meant. So I think he said boost box, but he meant like pedal box or pedal commander. I don't have either of them. Do I plan on having one? Yes, indeed. I want one, but I want one. I said I planned on having it, but it all depends on what route I go with my vehicle, especially with that pedal box or pedal commander. Now, let me tell you what these things do. First, let me talk about the reviews on these. Now, the pedal box have great reviews, excellent reviews. I really haven't seen anything bad or heard anything bad about the pedal box. Pedal Commander have great reviews also, but they have some bad reviews. People are always talking about the Pedal Commander always throw a check engine light. Now, I don't have one. You know, I can't speak on it, but it's all about how you install these things also. You have to do the installation right, or you could throw a check engine light. Or I could be wrong, and the Pedal Commander just throw check engine lights on certain vehicles or whenever it wants to. I don't know. But what the pedal box and pedal commander does, it does not, I repeat, it does not increase your horsepower. Not at all. No. Of course, you're going to need power adders for your vehicle if you're going to increase horsepower. Certain things, certain bolt-ons or... Oh, something just passed by. Sounded good. Anyway. Or you can do certain things like a cam, the headers, the intake, the internals, you know what I mean? What else? What is it called? It's so many things you can do to add power. And if I was to do that without going forced induction, I'm gonna add a pedal box, not the pedal commander, but the pedal box. There's a lot of noise going on out here. I just lost my train of thought. Anyway, so that's basically it. All I have to say about the pedal box, pedal commander. I can't do it. I can't do really speak on it because I don't have one. I didn't really do all that much research. I just know from seeing other people with pedal boxes and pedal commanders on videos. Now, somebody asked me, what's the best way to get a great deal when buying a V8 or buying a new car? The best answer I can give you, this, I'm telling you, man, I spent a lot of time doing this on the last video, man, that I got corrupted. That ended up corrupting, but the best advice that I can give you is do your research. Plenty and plenty of research. You have to know the price of your car. Even on a lot of these websites with buying a new car, like the major dealers, they have something where you put in your credit score, the APR, you know. When I put in my APR, I put in the APR that I had for the car that I had previously. It's kind of high, but, you know, I did that on purpose to see where I would be at if I was going to be on that APR again. And then do a lower APR to see, just in case. You always want to fight for the lowest APR. Try to get the lowest APR. have your down payment ready. If you need a down payment, your trade-in, you know the value of your trade-in. Now, what I mean by know the value of a trade-in is there is a trade-in price that they're going to give you. It might be a little bit of a low ball, but you could fight for a little bit more. Now, with me, I got a lot more than I expected. And they, you know, that put me in a good spot. What was I saying? You got to look at incentives too. With me, I ended up with a certain incentive because of being prior service. So you have to know these things. You have to do your research. And when you go up there, know which car you want. Don't let them let them tell you what kind of car they could put you in. Tell them you want to be in the car you want to be in. All right? So if you can't do it then, do it later whenever you're situated, you know, but you have to keep your eyes on that prize. You know what I mean? You know, sometimes you get distracted by things that pop up. Certain things are more important. I understand. But if you want that, you have to keep your eyes on that prize also. And you have to know there is more than one dealership. There's more than one dealership. If you have to travel to another dealership, then do that. They might, let me tell you what happened to me. I had my journey. But like I said, I'm a Chevy man too. Chevy was number one for me at first. So I went to Chevy. I said, I want to be in the SS or 1500. But it's got to be this model 1500 or it's got to be an SS Camaro. Told them what my credit score is. And I told them, you know, pretty soon, you know, the money situation, whatever, down payment situation. And then I told them, you know, the price of or what I owe on my journey. These dudes didn't even try to put me in the car I wanted. They didn't even try to put me in the truck I wanted. They brought out a used truck. Nothing new. I said I wanted to be in something new. I want to be in a new SS or a new pickup. Either one. They didn't even try. That's when I knew Chevy was... No. I went to Dodge. Man, it was like, hey man, come on in, man. We're gonna put you in there. It might not be the payments you want, but we're gonna get you in there. See, if Chevy would have said that or tried, you know, I'd probably be in the SS Camaro. And my name would have been Chevy Amere or SS Amere. No way. I don't know what it, but I would have kept my old name. Anyway, it goes, man. Hey, they didn't want to try. So that's what I'm telling you. You got to shop around. Don't let that one dealership, because there's plenty of Dodge dealerships. I wanted a Dodge, okay? After Chevy didn't put that bad taste in my mouth, I went to Dodge. Now, if they couldn't do it, they tried. And that's what I'm telling you, man, you have to pay attention to people too. You have to look at their demeanor if they really want to put you in that car. So that helps you out too. Oh man, I don't know, man. I didn't got off a little bit off topic, man. But anyway, you have to shop around also. You have to look at Dodge website too. Look at the price of the car and see where you could be at. And then shop around. I didn't do that all that much shopping around because I already knew what I wanted. And plus, you know, there was a kind of a shortage around the time I got my car because the factories shut down for a while. The factories shut down. Dodge shut down. Chevy, Ford, Cadillac, all of them, they were shut down for COVID. So I ended up in a good spot because of that also. I wish I had more information for you. I wish I could tell you, like, if there's a certain formula that's gonna put you exactly where you wanna be at. But I just don't have it, man. This is all, this, I mean, to this, to me, to you, I'm gonna be honest, man, it's always a learning experience. So, the deal that you get is probably be a better deal or a worse deal. I don't know what's gonna happen for you, man, or any of you guys. But I do wish the best of luck for you. And I want to see you guys in this. I want to see you guys in the Hellcat. I want to see you guys in the Scat Pack. I want to see you guys in the RT or GT, XXT, whichever one you want to be in, man. I want y'all to get there. Man, I don't know how to get you there. I don't have the exact formula. But all I can tell you is do your research. Do your research. Know your money. Know your pockets. Know your pockets. I guess that's it, man. I don't have much else to tell you, man. So, like I said, I wish everybody luck that's trying to get into a new vehicle. And congratulations to everybody that did jump into their Mopar situation, man. Because I know a couple of you guys just jumped into one. I know somebody was telling me they just got into it like a month ago. 2-3 weeks ago, something like that. Hey man, congratulations. Man, it's a beautiful feeling when you get in the car that you want. You treat your car differently, man. I mean, there's something about when you get what you want. And that's another thing. Make sure you get what you want. Not what somebody else wants for you. Or what somebody else wants you to have. Because this is going to be yours. You're going to be paying for it. All right? So, make sure you check up on them insurance prices too, man. You know, you gotta make sure you're able to handle insurance also. And another thing, somebody wanted me to do a video about, this was a while ago, but talking about how much I paid for my car, this, that, and the other, you know, the financial, really deep into the financial part. Like I said before, man, I cannot do that until I have way, way more subscribers. That's why I keep telling y'all, like, comment, share, subscribe. Once I get to the, I'm not gonna hold y'all. I gotta get to the point where I'm monetized to talk about money. Once I'm monetized, then we'll talk about the money part. But until then, I can't. Because yeah, I gotta keep something. You know what I mean? You know? I'll tell you how much I pay for certain add-ons that I do. I mean, if it's not too much, like if I do the mid muffler, I'm gonna tell you exactly how much that is, which I'm hoping I can do this month. Some things came up and it's looking kind of shaky for me, but I could hopefully do it. The JLT intake, told y'all how much. I want to do a cold air intake. I want to do the installation of my amp. I'm gonna tell you how much. If it's not too much, I'm gonna tell you how much it is. You know what I mean? Because it's because I don't want you to think these are hard to get to. These are not hard goals. These are not hard goals to get to. So, one last thing before I get off this thing, because I'm about to close this out. Because I'm already running too long on the talking. But I'm going to tell you one last thing. I want you guys to take this very serious. When I went to get my car, I didn't tell nobody. I told one person, maybe two people. I told two people. That's it. Because people would try to trample on your dreams, man. They would say things just to be rude, just to be out of pocket, man. So you got to keep certain things to yourself, man. So when you going to get your car, or when you're trying to get your car, keep it to yourself. You know what I mean? Keep your goals to yourself. I mean, throughout anything, keep your goals to yourself, because there are people out there that just gonna hate for no reason. All right, I'm gonna tell you, this is a true story, man. I had to deal with this shit with my ex-wife, man, telling her my goals and everything, and she used to shit on me. So she's not the only person that used to shit on me, but you got to keep your goals to yourself, man. Just keep it to yourself. Don't tell nobody nothing. And you know, and when it happens for you, let them congratulate you, all right? Because they're gonna be like, I mean, I didn't know you was doing all that. There's a reason why. So, hey man, I don't know why I said that, man. But I just want everybody to be able to have what they want without somebody trying to, you know, get in their ear, you know? Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and close this out. Like, comment, share, subscribe, leave a comment in the comment section about whatever kind of video you wanna see next. If I can do it, I will do it. Look like it's about to storm. Please share the videos, man. Share the videos and browse, man. Man, put your people on these videos, man. I mean, let me tell you something, man. Some videos I have crazy amount of views. And then some, you know, but it's slowly picking up. So I just need for it to get out there, man. I got to do my part too. I got to do my part too. You guys are right. I got to do my part too. And I'm working on it. So anyway, man, like, comment, share, subscribe. Is there anything else I'm forgetting? You guys know how I do it. As you were. Boy, this video ran too long, and I'm so sorry.